Dímelo, mi gente linda. What's up? Welcome back to our sketch comedy show, Go Off. I'm Julissa Calderon.
And I'm Jess Marie Garcia, and this is our season finale.
Listen, I can't believe it is the season finale. What even is time?
Girl, somehow 2022 is only weeks away, and I'm still processing the phase of 2020 when we were cutting our own bangs.
Not the bangs. The bangs.
The bangs.
The bangs. I feel you, though. I don't know how we got here so quick, but we've had so much fun bringing out sketches this season.
Yo, the most fun. And since it's the holiday season, we've got some Christmas goodies for you in the finale episode, plus a whole bunch of guests. But let's channel the drama today because it's time to
go off.
Okay, to everyone nostalgic for a little holiday mess, get into this dysfunctional Nochebuena dinner.
Truly, nothing makes me choose violence like my tíos after four too many coquitos.
Bienvenidos.
Hola. Qué bueno que vinieron.
¡Nochebuena, bitches!
Oh, is it just us this Nochebuena? Decorations are kind of lacking, no?
What up, tío César? You're looking especially at Bennett, as always.
Has empezado temprano la fiesta.
Shown up.
Ooh, let's tell him, let's tell him. Oh, hey, everybody. I think we should hold off on the presents.
¿De qué estás hablando?
Because we have some crazy news.
¿Estás embarazada?
What? No, do I look pregnant?
What? No, you look fire.
I've been pounding coquito.
Ya verán la noticia que les tengo.
Wait, we haven't said our thing yet. Okay, everyone. We're going vegan.
¿Qué?
¿Qué has dicho?
We're going vegan.
Hace hambre, ¿no? La mesa está lista. Si quieren, traigo más.
¿Quién de las dos está embarazada?
Hey,
what the fuck, tío? Neither of us is pregnant. Damn.
Yeah, we're really going vegan.
Yeah, just cutting out meat and dairy and stuff.
See, now there's no need to smuggle jamón ibérico into the country anymore, huh?
Vaya, por Dios.
What? Everyone knows you do it.
A ver, no se confundan que yo de verdad sí estoy muy feliz con la decisión que tomaron, ¿eh?
Ay, pues yo creo que esto que acaban de hacer
no es correcto.
Va en contra de las reglas de Dios.
Well, technically, biologically, we weren't made to drink milk or cheese or like meats because of how our intestines and how God made us. I read it in an article. Julissa, tell them about the article.
Oh, yeah, like Beyond Meat, Impossible Meat, that's another one. The other meat.
Yeah, and there's like cashews and oat milk. White people do it all the time.
Tú puedes embarrarnos la cara con tus perversiones, con tus desviaciones, y nosotros nos tenemos que quedar calladitos.
See, I know they wouldn't understand.
Why aren't you guys more supportive? Every major city supports a vegan lifestyle, except maybe Chicago.
Bueno, y me preguntas que por qué me fui a estudiar a Chicago.
We're even gonna start a new Instagram account about it.
The twisted turnip.
¿Chueco?
Ay, primo, I know you suggested the tasty turnip, but twisted sounds sexier.
Eso no es normal. Es asqueroso.
No. Turnip, like turnip. Damn, we're just brainstorming.
Eres un lazcano, y te guste o no, eso lo vas a respetar.
Not until you respect the animals.
And Chema, why are you acting all shocked? Chema's gluten-free, everybody.
Yo no le hago daño a nadie.
Repite lo que has dicho.
¿Quieres que te lo repita?
Why do you think he only eats corn tortillas?
Eso.
Hey,
oh my God.
Ya fue suficiente.
Tío, why are you mad? Isn't that gluten-free cookbook in the kitchen yours?
Ya está, ya.
Niégalo.
Está.
Niégalo.
¿Es tuyo?
No.
No.
It's right there. Sin palabras. Gluten-free cooking that leaves you speechless.
I see it.
Vaya. Sin palabras.
Hi, Tia. Quick question. Did you happen to get the text about the jackfruit? Pozole? Just... No? Okay.
This side of the family gets so dramatic. Ugh. Next year, let's do that sign. Listen, you know it wouldn't be Christmas without some ho-ho-hos coming out of the woodworks and trying to slide back into your life.
Fuck boys take no holidays off.
I swear these men be doing too much. I don't need to get a Merry Christmas, I miss you, Feliz Navidad, tell your mama say hello, what are y'all cooking this year? Don't worry, you don't need a reply text from someone who's Feliz Navidad to me.
Oh, I like that. Mm-hmm. Now, if you too are being haunted by the fuckboys of Christmas past, you might like this Christmas carol.
At the first Christmas party, a fuckboy texted me, "Senos a clan emoji."
At the second Christmas party, a fuckboy texted me, "What are you wearing? I'm out clubbing, why don't you join me?"
At the third Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "These are all my girlfriends, but they're not my girlfriends. We're just close, we split amicably."
At the fourth Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "Can I crash at your place? I swear I'm not homeless. I sleep in my Prius, 'cause it saves me a lot of money."
At the fifth Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "No labels, please. Yes, I really like you, but I need to find myself. It's a process, I call my journey."
At the sixth Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "Here, hold on tightly, do you trust me? I can show you the world, Jasmine, that's my friend Abu. What was that? Oh, your name is Brittany."
At the seventh Christmas party, my tío said to me, "Hola, sobrina, wow, how you filled out? Come hug me, please. Hey, ¿a dónde vas? Ay, por coquito for los dos. I don't know why your tía left me."
At the eighth Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "Here, try this smoothie, tasty and nutritious. Plus, you make money called Herbalife. It's so easy to join, just give me your home address. I swear it's not a pyramid scheme."
At the ninth Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "Damn, it's been so long, what's up since high school? Yeah, I still play music when I'm not bartending. Here's Wonderwall. Do you wanna hear this bass riff? I still live at home. Do you need me to text the Addy?"
At the 10th Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "My name is Ulysses, wanna hear a poem? Wrote it when I saw you, it's my magnum opus. Hoping that your name is Penelope. I've been on a quest to meet you, lasted 20 years. Open mic starts at 7:30.
At the 11th Christmas party, a fuckboy said to me, "Yes, I am married, that doesn't stop me. Here's your own apartment, rings made of diamonds, keys to a Tesla, Amex for your travels. Yes, I'm wealthy. Money's just a concept, all your student loans are paid. Just don't call when I'm with my family."
At the 12th Christmas party, a fuckboy texted me, "Hey, girl, you still up? Heading back to my crib. I'll be there in 20. Are you down for beer pong? Please don't still be angry. She means nothing to me. We can take it easy. Netflix and chill. Come on, baby, I swear to you, we'll go on a date. Let me prove just what you mean to me."
Oh, my bad, my boy just called me. How about next week?
Ooh, that was a little too real.
A lot real. We all just trying to find love, like in those Christmas rom-com movies.
You know where a career woman who's too busy to date finds romance with a prince who time travels through the magic of Christmas to a cute small town, and then they help save a struggling family small business to learn what the holiday spirit is all about?
God damn. There's just something about a cheesy Christmas movie that sparks joy, which got us thinking, who comes up with these Christmas movie ideas? Here's a sneak peek at how the magic happens.
Ooh.
Hit it.
All right, ladies, thank you so much for being here. Not only is the Christmas rom-com always a box office favorite for us, but we're looking to put a fresh, new spin on important issues that audiences really care about.
Helen, you're gonna love what I have for you today.
Okay. It's an honor to pitch for you, Helen.
Great, let's get started. How about Rose, would you like to start?
Okay.
A newspaper magnate learns the meaning of life with a visit from his childhood sled on Christmas. We film it in black and white. It's called Citizen Candy Cane.
I love it. I mean, it is exactly what we're looking for. You know, it's a fresh take on Christmas. Okay, Charlotte, what do you got?
Yeah, totally. Okay. A female Supreme Court clerk intervenes with an immigration case to save a family from being deported just in time for Christmas. Right?
Well, I don't really get it.
What part? What do you mean?
Is it like a few good men on Christmas? You know, I'm having a hard time really seeing it.
I hear you. Totally understand. But no, I don't think you can see it because it's a completely new idea, like what you had said earlier, right?
Right. Okay. Why don't we hear another pitch from Rose?
Two lovers, one rich, one poor, fall in love on an ocean liner that crashes into an iceberg.
An ocean liner that crashes into an iceberg.
On Christmas. Merry ice to meet you.
Extraordinary. That is so fresh. And that is truly the message of Christmas.
You know, it kind of sounds like Titanic. Am I?
Yeah, but on Christmas. Okay, was it Charlotte? Why don't we give that another go?
Yeah, no, okay. Totally. All right, okay. A whip-smart female archaeologist, women empowerment, visit the site of the resurrection where she meets a handsome guide who helps her discover the meaning of love.
Ooh.
Right?
Oh, that's it? I'm sorry. What does that have to do with Christmas?
Well, you know, the Jesus part.
The Jesus part, okay.
I'm so embarrassed. I also brought in an archaeologist.
Oh, no, please, go ahead. Something that's better than that one.
All right, okay. Two archaeologists fall in love while visiting the North Pole, where dinosaurs have escaped from a new theme park on Christmas. We call it Jurassic Parka.
Jurassic Park, that is incredible!
Okay, well, if you like that, how about Fa-la-la-la-lalo me beyond the glass ceiling, a triumphant tale again of a woman who stands
okay,
up...
Okay, Charlotte?
Yeah?
How did you become the VP of comedy?
Oh, I'm the VP of drama.
Oh, that makes sense.
A drama about a group of car thieves that fall in love while being visited by the ghost of car chase past. Helen, the past and the curious. There could be like 10 of...
Nothing says Christmas like a franchise.
I'm sorry. In the beginning, did you say you wanted fresh ideas?
No. Of course we do. Of course we do. We just want a new, fresh idea that we already know will work.
I have another, if I may.
By all means, please.
A young boy is left at home by his family on his favorite holiday and has to fight off a pair of bumbling robbers.
Okay, that's great, but Home Alone is already set on Christmas.
That's already a movie.
Charlotte, Helen. Here, the kid is left alone on Martin Luther King Day. It's called I Have a Dream of Being Left Home Alone.
Historical relevance, cultural awareness, market share expansion. Rose, I love you more than my own flippin' daughter.
Thank you so much, Helen.
Okay, I think I get what we're going for here. I'm getting it. Okay.
Let's
go. Okay, all right. 12 Years a Slave!
Oh my God, no.
I just thought...
Absolutely not. Please leave.
I'm so sorry.
Stop.
I'm so sorry. I'm really sorry.
Ashley, get security.
Okay, I'm gonna, you don't have to do that.
5-2, Latina, Bob.
That's our show, y'all! Thank you so much for laughing with us this season! Wait. Before we say farewell, I want to give a very special congratulations to my co-host and friend on her own little gift under the tree. I am so happy for you. Congratulations.
Thank you. This is why we forced everyone to film us from the waist up.
Listen, we having a baby, y'all.
The first go off baby. And thank you to all the guests who came through to join us. Y'all were amazing.
So amazing. We are wishing you and yours happy holidays filled with blessings and all the good things.
And all the consensual sex.
Yeah, that too. We want that.
Till next time.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Go off! Get out.
Like the movie? Because we can do something like—
Stop talking.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Silencio.
I'm really sorry.
Security?
Okay, I'm gonna, you don't have to do that.